Hello world! In this video, I am going to talk about the food science, technology and nutrition of cornflakes. I welcome you to the YouTube channel of researchyourfood.com. You can find much more exclusive content at our site. The mission of researchyourfood.com is bringing food science to the consumers. Now let's get into the topic. First of all, let us take a look at the typical Western breakfast at the beginning of the 20th century. It used to consist of mainly animal-based foods such as bacon, eggs, sausages, fish, sandwiches made of ham and eggs, and cold meat. This diet usually consists of a lot of fat, cholesterol, calories, and sodium. People also used to consume bread, pancakes, coffee, and tea. Dr. John Hovey Kellogg was experimenting a soft breakfast food for the patients at Battle Creek Sanatorium in the year 1877. He developed a product and named it as granola and was serving it to the patients at the sanatorium. C.W. Post visited the sanatorium and was very impressed by the cereals provided there and thought of the commercial possibilities of them and went on to form Postum Cereal Company in the year 1895. In the year of 1894, Dr. John Hovey Kellogg and Will Keith Kellogg accidentally developed first flaked cereals with wheat. After some time, the same technique was used with corn and it led to the discovery of cornflakes. Later, Will Keith Kellogg founded Battle Creek Toasted Cornflake Company in the year 1906. It was later named as Kellogg Company and is a highly successful cereal company even today. Cornflakes released in the market during that time offered convenience, and the easily digestible nature of them made people slowly move towards them. This transition made people consume more carbohydrate-rich food, which by the end of 20th century eventually led to the global pandemics such as diabetes and metabolic syndrome. Now let us understand the manufacturing method of cornflakes in brief. There are specific temperature, pressure, time, and other technical details that are strictly followed during the process. But in this video, to simplify the process, I will explain only the steps followed in making the cornflakes. Generally, sun-dried corn is used for making cornflakes. But the actual process of cornflakes starts with corn grits. Corn grits are obtained when the corn undergoes dry milling. Dry milling process of corn produces corn grits, corn meal, germ, corn flour, and others. The major portion of the corn grits is carbohydrate. Corn grits are then blended with other ingredients such as water, sugar, salt, malt, etc. This blend undergoes steam cooking in a batch or continuous cooker. Then the cooked material is dried to the desired flaking moisture. This dried material is fed to the rollers to achieve the right flake thickness. Though the flakes are formed at this stage, they have very high moisture content and are very soft. These flakes undergo toasting in high temperature ovens. Here the moisture content is brought to around 6 to 7%. After this step, the cornflakes are cooled and packed. Now let us look at the nutritional value of two brands of cornflakes. The first one is Kellogg's Cornflakes Original from the US and the second one is Cornflakes from Tesco of UK. Both brands have at least 30% recommended dietary intake of several vitamins and minerals per serving. Let us look at the macronutrients composition here. Both the brands of cornflakes have more than 85% carbohydrate content and have a little dietary fiber. As we can see, both have added sugar. The protein content of both of them is around 7.5%. Most of the cereals generally have similar content of protein, with rice having the least amount. We can say that the protein content of cornflakes is of moderate level. If we see the fat content of Kellogg's, it is zero, whereas Tesco has 1.2 grams of it. This analysis is to understand what the nutritional quality of plain cornflakes is. But the silver lining here is, they are mostly consumed with milk. When we add milk to the flakes, the protein content increases and the overall carbohydrate percentage decreases, depending on what type of milk you use, skim milk or full cream milk. The fat content increases. Cornflakes brands use this addition of milk to their advantage and try to prove that cornflakes are one of the healthiest options in the market. By adding milk of specific type and specific amount, they try to make the mixture appear really balanced. For example, in the case of the Kellogg's cornflakes of the US, the suggested usage of milk type is skimmed milk with zero fat. Whereas in the Indian version of Kellogg's cornflakes, it is the milk with 4.5% of fat. Many other brands also do the similar thing. But at the same time, the addition of milk definitely enhances the overall nutrition of the cornflakes. The dietary fiber is quite less in the cornflakes and milk does not have any of it. So I suggest you to add some nuts and fruits to your overall diet. Texture plays the most important role among all the sensory properties of cornflakes. Cornflakes generally have around 6 to 7% moisture content. At this moisture content, they are very crisp, and when the cold milk is added to them for consumption, they stay crisp for around 3 to 5 minutes. But once the package is opened, they quickly pick up the moisture from the atmosphere. So they must be immediately shifted to an airtight container. Flavor plays the second most important role. Since most brands of cornflakes contain added vitamins and minerals, they need to be protected from oxidation by proper packaging and further usage after opening. Cornflakes with less added sugar taste bland when milk is added to them. The reason for the bland taste is milk. Milk contains lactose as a sugar and it is just 0.16 times sweeter to table sugar, that is sucrose. But after the addition of little sugar, they taste quite good. Cornflakes generally cost lesser when compared to other breakfast cereals such as muesli, granola and other wheat-based cereals in most of the markets in the world. Among the breakfast cereals, plain instant oats cost lesser than cornflakes in some markets. We can say that cornflakes are generally budget-friendly breakfast cereals in most parts of the world. Flavored cornflakes and cornflakes with added nuts generally cost significantly higher. A food product performs well in the convenience section when the preparation time required is as less as possible and preparation needs very little mental and physical effort. Cornflakes perform exceptionally well as per this criteria, as we just need to add cold milk to consume them. When we are hungry and don't have patience to cook, they can help us as a quick breakfast or meal with moderately good nutrition. Since we don't need to cook them, the dishwashing effort, which is a physical effort, is reduced. For some foods, we need to follow the prescribed method of preparation, which needs mental effort. This is not the case with cornflakes, as we can just add cold milk and consume them. To conclude, cornflakes have moderately good nutrition and perform very well in the category of convenience. Consuming them without milk makes them not a very healthy option. When they are consumed with milk and little added sugar, they can be a good breakfast for physically active people. At the same time, people suffering from diseases such as diabetes and metabolic syndrome must try to restrict the use of cornflakes, as they are generally very high in their carbohydrate content. In the end, I thank you very much for watching this video. To get the latest updates about our videos, consider subscribing to our YouTube channel and follow researchyourfood.com website. I hope to see you in my next video.